I don't think that I have to introduce the eminent personality of Visakhapatnam in music, Shivi Sita Ramai Garu. But yet, I have to do this. He is known for his sincerity, commitment, and seriousness for good music. He could not learn classical music through Guru Sishya Parampara. Due to his 18 years of military service, he served in Air Force from 1971 to 89. His full-time occupation as Inspector, Superintendent of Customs, Central Excise and Service Tax from 1992 to 2012, and thereafter further occupation as an advocate after his retirement. Yet, he has been fortunate that as a youngster under 18, for the musical merits poured into him by the Almighty through his parents, and for the exposure to listening to the great exponents of classical music who used to present vocal and instrumental music at the private gatherings of his father, who was a renowned multi-faced artist by himself. Thereafter, he has been improving his levels by critical and meticulous listening to the masterworks of legends of Hindustani classical music, vocal and instrumental. Shri V. Sitaramaya says in his own words, "Though I had no master, it does not mean that I were not a disciple. Ustad Bismillah Khan is my inspiration. Every sound I hear is my guru. I am Ekalavya Sishya to all legends whose works fascinated me. I am only an amateur, and out of my passion for classical music, I try to present Hindustani classical music at my best through self-learning." Here we have to note that he in his own words said, "I am the Ekalavya Sishya." We know pretty well that Ekalavya was more perfect than so-called Sabyasachi Arjuna in some fields. He admits that is his refinement to say, "Though there was no guru, direct guru, I am Ekalavya Sishya of so many eminents." Generally, an instrumental performer continues with the khayal style composition called gat in a particular taal and repeats it several times, varying the gat slightly each time. At this point, the tabla maestro joins the instrumentalist and improvises for several cycles of teka, synchronizing at a sum after a tihai. Thereafter, the instrumentalist alternates between the gat and improvisation, progressing from simpler to more complex pattern, both rhythmically and melodically. In present, the gats, the unmetered alap is very short and is followed by a gat in a slower tempo, and then vistar is followed by the antaras. Now I invite Sri Sitaramai Garu to present a gat in Rag Purvi and Rag Sohni. Rag Purvi belongs to Purvi Thought. It's a sunset raga, mostly played between 6 p.m. and 9 p.m. It uses all seven notes in the ascent and descent. Rishabh and Dhaivat are komal. Madhyam is both Shuddh and Tivra, while Gandhar and Nishad are Shuddh. Then, Rag Sohni is derived from Marwa Thought. It's a raga mostly played between 9 p.m. and 12 p.m. It uses Shadjam, Gandhar, Tivra Madhyam, Dhaivat, Nishad in ascent, and Tar Shadjam, Nishad, Dhaivat, Tivra Madhyam, Komal, Rishab in the descent. Now I invite Shri Sitaramai Garu to present Rag Purvi and Rag Sohni. This classical starts and ends up with Madhya Leh.
Thank you. Thank you.
Rag Yaman is an important raga which is heard frequently. It often forms a part of evening performances besides being one of the first ragas taught to the beginner. Although it is commonly believed that Rag Yaman was composed by Amir Khusrow, this raga has been in existence, at least in its basic form, from well before the Islamic period.